Juvenile Education Awareness Project. During the past 15 years, Sandy Shevack and Martin Sostre, two dedicated humanitarian activists, have worked unceasingly to rebuild decayed inner city structures. Through their efforts, adults, juveniles, and children have benefited. Over 100 inner city juveniles have learned marketable skills. Adults have been provided with affordable, decent housing, and children have a safe educational daycare center. These two men from vastly different backgrounds are the best example of grassroots activism. Hustling for grants and rolling up their sleeves, they demonstrate just what two men can do to change and empower a community. Martin Sostre was born in Harlem, New York on March 20th, 1923. Martin's life experiences are vast. He has been a street hustler, a heroin dealer, a jailhouse lawyer, a black Muslim, and one of the few Americans adopted by Amnesty International as a political prisoner of conscience. Martin Sostre is a legend in the activist community. His political activism is documented in the book, The Crime of Martin Sostre by Vincent Copeland, and in the documentary film, Frame Up, The Imprisonment of Martin Sostre, produced by the Pacific Street Film Collective. Stephen Fischler, Joel Schuller, and Howard Blatt as producers. Sandy Shevack was born November 11, 1954, in Passaic, New Jersey. Sandy attended elementary and high schools in Passaic, New Jersey, and he earned a bachelor's degree in sociology from William Patterson College in Wayne, New Jersey. During his college education, Sandy found himself drawn to social injustices and human rights issues. He has dedicated his life's work to social and political activism. Undaunted, Sandy actively participates in demonstrations, protests, and grassroots movements with community-based organizations. His activism brought him into contact with Rahway State Prison's Lifers Group. The group's efforts to deter juveniles away from a life of crime was a subject of the 1979 Academy Award-winning documentary film, Scared Straight, which Sandy helped produce. Sandy also became involved with Amnesty International, the group that identified Martin as a political prisoner, and in 1976 helped him obtain executive clemency from New York Governor Hugh Carey. Through associates, Sandy and Martin met. From their common ideology to tangibly improve the quality of life for inner city residents and their abilities and skills, Sandy as a grant writer and Martin as a carpentry master, the two men formed a relationship, and in 1981 they founded the Juvenile Education and Awareness Project. The project involves empowering young people by employing them and teaching them basic carpentry and work skills. Through the Juvenile Education Awareness Project, youth receive on-the-job training as they renovate vacant buildings into affordable, decent housing for low-income families. These young men and women learn sheetrocking, framing, tiling, flooring, sanding, painting, and how to read blueprints. Since 1983, Sostre and Shevack have provided employment and training opportunities to over 100 teenagers from Patterson and Passaic. Together, they have renovated four buildings in Passaic, which includes the Juvenile Education and Awareness Project's Community Center and Headquarters, located at 40 Market Street. In 1988, the Juvenile Education and Awareness Project purchased a huge two-story, burnt-out brick building located at 103 North Main Street in Patterson. This building had been a vacant eyesore and a danger for over 7 years. Operating on a shoestring budget, it took more than 3.5 years to renovate the building. Ironically, this structure, built in 1901, was initially the home of the First Ward Republican Club and then later served as headquarters of the North Side Forces, an anti-poverty group active in the 60s and 70s. Today, through the hard work of Martin Sostre, Sandy Shevack, and the participants of the Juvenile Education Awareness Project, the building houses the New World Daycare Center, which is sponsored by the Juvenile Education and Awareness Project. The New World Daycare Center is licensed by the state of New Jersey and serves 55 local children ages 2.5 to 6 years old. The director of the center, Malika Abdullah, ensures the program is educationally orientated. This helps children make a successful transition to public school ready to learn. In addition to teaching inner city youth marketable job skills, the project strives to enlighten and empower youth to take control of their lives and their community. Through their considerable contacts and resources, Sostre and Shevack bring adults and juveniles into contact with many famous social and political figures. They present movies and videos and lectures regarding human rights issues. The Juvenile Education and Awareness Project also takes inner city youth on environmental awareness and wilderness survival field trips. For many youth, these field trips are their first experience being in the wilderness away from the inner city. Martin Sostre and Sandy Shevack have unique personal histories of community, international, and human rights activism. Both men have been involved in movements to end apartheid in South Africa, worked relief projects in El Salvador, Guatemala, and Nicaragua, and they continue in their efforts to end the blockade of Cuba. The Juvenile Education and Awareness Project has received many awards for its successful efforts. Some of these awards are: in 1984, the City of Passaic's Chamber of Commerce Award; in 1985, the Passaic BSI and BIL Community Service Award; in 1992, the Passaic Valley United Way Innovative Project Award; in 1994, the Abby Hoffman Activist Foundation Award; in 1995, the Bergen Record Newspaper Community Service Award; and in 1996, the Community Foundation of New Jersey Neighborhood Leadership Initiative Fellowship Award. Some of the activities of the Juvenile Education and Awareness Project has been covered by local cable television programs. Let's take a look at two video clips from this coverage.
Okay, so we're down here at the Juvenile Education Awareness Center. We're speaking with the director, Sandy Shevack. How you doing, Sam?
Thanks, Sam.
Good. So listen, can you give us some history of the project, the beginning and so forth?
Sure.
Thanks, Sam.
And our project started in January 1983 after about a year and a half. Martin Sostre and I secured enough funding from private foundations to purchase the building that we're located in right now, 40 Market Street. It took us about 9 months. We renovated it into a community center, and that was in 83. In 84, we renovated, along with local youths, a six-family building on 3rd Street. The following year, in 85, a two-family building on 6th Street. In 87, a six-family building on Oak Street. And it took us 3.5 years, from 1988 to 91, we renovated a burned-out building in Patterson, which is now our New World Daycare Center. So in addition to providing young people with jobs, creating low-income affordable housing, creating educationally-oriented daycare centers, we're showing tangible results in the community. And this is what's necessary. There's so many agencies that get funded that that don't produce tangible results, and we're very proud of our record of track record of success with young people, our track record of success in bringing about some social change in communities like Passaic and Patterson, which are in dire need. What we're doing here this summer is replacing the roof so that we could reopen our communities. What we're doing here is at 40 Market Street Community Center. It's been closed for quite a while because this is the original roof that was constructed and completed in 1914, around the time of the First World War. So what we're in the process of doing this summer with the young people here in Passaic is tearing up the roof. You see they're progressing pretty quick because I gotta keep moving back. We're going to replace the beams that need to be replaced, put plywood down, and put the tar paper and rubber on top of it. And then we'll be ready to open up our community center once again. You see, when you give young people an opportunity for employment and an opportunity to learn skills, they'll jump right into it, as they're doing here. They're just learning the preliminary phases now, but later this week we'll actually start putting down the plywood.
And as they tear up new parts of the roof, they have to progress backwards in order to get footage, right?
Right, right.
Looks like a nice size roof. What's the size of this?
Well, this particular area is 75 feet by 25 feet.
Okay.
These here are what you see are the original beams.
Mm.
You know, it's very safe what we're doing because below this, there's another level, and you see the guys are standing on planks and beams below that, so there's not any real danger. If we could rebuild Japan, if we could rebuild Germany after World War II, then definitely we could rebuild Patterson and Newark and New York City and all the cities throughout the country, give the youths an opportunity for employment, to learn skills, but it's not going to happen unless people organize and demand political change.
Daycare center is that people need to be involved in the community. don't have any money, you have to use labor. And we could do it, so can people in the black community that care can do it. And this is what we're trying to get across. At least that's what it meant to me.
My name is David Sandy Shevack, and I'm a Sostre of the Juvenile Education Awareness Project for the most innovative project in Patterson for the 1991-1992. The reason I nominated them is because the Juvenile Education Awareness Project is providing a necessary service to the children of Patterson and providing daycare to families that ordinarily wouldn't receive daycare.
This is the building that it was originally. As you can see, it was wood, now it's brick. And inside, like I said, it was, you can see here how it was on the inside. There was a fire at the back here where you could see right through the ceiling, through the roof. And then you could see how it was actually shaping up. And you could see how it's coming to life from where it was here. Here we are, the stench and the dust was so overpowering. We had to use masks. It's sandy here, but most of us had to use masks because of the dust and the stench. And you can see here some of this program, kids putting up sheetrock. Here's Sandy putting up tile. You can see it coming to life here, in the tile, the sinks, See, it's like coming to life, a dead building coming to life.
A dead building has come to life. The New World Daycare Center is a place where wonderful futures begin for inner city children just like Chandra.
It's time that we start taking America back. We start taking back and showing people, you can do something to improve your condition. And that you have to be independent, you have to stand for something. And these guys set out, they planned this years ago, and they stuck with it. You have to stick with it. If you have a hope or a dream that you want to bring something across to deliver to people, this is the way to do it. You have to be a tough person and stick together and continue until you finish the project.
I'm sure that you will agree that Martin Sostre and Sandy Shevack are truly two activists that back up their words with action.